Tell us about the advertising load. I know this is something that we don't really know in the States. I know that the broadcasters are limited by the amount of ads that they can carry in a period of time. Mm-hmm. Online, it's different. How does the ad load work out for online entertainment programming in the UK and in Europe? Is it different? Are there opportunities there?
I think it's something we're still experimenting with to some extent, and we're being very careful not to upset the user experience. But at the same time, we've just undertaken quite a lot of research across Europe and found that advertising, people aren't offended by it or aren't upset by it. It's actually something that they accept as long as it's done in a sort of a way that's mindful of the experience. And if it's interesting advertising, they sometimes even like it. So.
Oh, so the advertising needs to be somehow personalized or of interest?
I think so, yeah, definitely. I think if you have advertising that's just totally at odds with the programming and the actual user who's watching that programming, it's not going to work for anyone, for the user or for the actual advertiser.
Tell us about sort of the platforms of consumption for this content.
Okay, so for us at the moment, online is probably the primary area, but mobile is an area that we've also been on, you know, different mobile networks for many years. Also, video on demand, so on television, video on demand services as well. I think with iPhone and Android and things like that, we'll see a lot more consumption of video through the mobile.
So are there people who are watching your program online or in mobile who may not have watched, you know, on the regular broadcast or satellite?
I think that's actually definitely true for our kids' brands. So there's this nostalgia feeling about some of our shows like Johnny Bravo and Cow and Chicken. And we wouldn't normally run those in airtime for our target children's audience, but people are starting to watch those on video on demand platforms quite a lot. We see sort of peaks at midnight, and we know it's not a 7-year-old. It's actually sort of 20-year-olds coming home that want to watch cartoons from their youth. So that's quite an interesting sort of trend.